Signal. My name is Mike Nourse. We're coming to you. Well, I was going to say live, but it's not at all live. We're coming to you pre-recorded from the basement of a house that shall remain anonymous until someone tells you whose house it is. But we're not going to talk about that now. D Shop is in the building. D Shop. Sophie joining us. The CEO. CEO of Palomo Industries, Gabe Palomo, dude, Birdie, Nat, we are rolling and ready to go. Took us a while to set everything up down here. We have a full cast tonight, and everything minus a drum set. But we have the man who knows how to make those things. feels probably, probably ends. It's the best time. Oh, there is a no more. It's a fantasy. Fantasy which lives. Sail up to you.
Come off with good eyes. let's recap for the audience here what took place over here last night, just as a setup. We've had our rehearsal space in this one building, band building, for probably like the last, what, 3 years?
Yeah, 2 or 3 years. It's been beautiful.
And the building is in the process of like looking for buyers and being sold. And basically, we are not having the room anymore as of the end of this month.
Yeah, we're one of the last bands to be clinging to a space there. Everyone else has moved out. We are on our way out, and this is a stab at what it's going to be like once we are out.
We're going to set up little mini studios in Mike's basement, which is where we're at right now, in Mike's lovely new house.
South side.
Basement.
And then Gabe's going to set up his own little recording situation in his basement.
On the west side.
West side.
Basement.
We have to west have one on the north basement. Side.
Yeah, I mean, well, we've got our little one.
North side.
And then my place could be Loop.
Loop side.
Loop.
Downtown.
We're all over Chicago.
That's the way. Yeah, we're keeping an eye on everything.
Just traveling.
So I think each space has its own different, will have its own different flair of the type of music that gets made. You guys want to talk about a little bit about what this environment produced musically? What kind of things we can do here? What we did here last night?
Mm-hmm.
We came in here and we kind of brought all of our gear from the studio and kind of set up a recording situation in Mike's basement.
We have Darren's electronic database of Utopia with digital tools, techniques, drums, rhythms, sounds in one corner of the man cave, which is the name being used right now for my little room in the basement.
The mic cave.
Oh, that's a good name. I like that. We've got a little Korg in another part of the room.
Korg keyboard
that's synthesizer-ish, so a lot of tweaking possibilities there. We've got a piano in the other room, a couple guitar amps in the other room.
Right.
And then last night, we should mention, Gabe was here with his laptop. And
my sister Birdie,
his wife Nat's sister Birdie, who was playing the Korg, and then he was doing beats and rhythms to go along with singing and guitar and piano and a nice collection of electronic and vocal experiments. And Darren and Sophie stayed over. Nat came back over this morning. We had brunch, which was great. Talked about stuff.
Yeah, Mike made some. What did you? It's the Mike special.
It's a breakfast mix, a mix bowl of sorts with potatoes and some onions and some fake meat and eggs and some nice sriracha sauce on there, and you got yourself a breakfast bowl of goodness. Some nice coffee, and then now we just get to come downstairs and add some last touches to our session and call it a day, call it a weekend.
Yeah, Darren, Sophie, how was your night at Shea Mike?
Excellent. I felt like it was a week of vacation, just get away. Feels like we went out of town.
Yeah. We woke up and there were a couple of cardinals in the garden, so that was nice to see.
Ah.
Good morning.
Nice view to wake up to,
How does different environments kind of affect how you the type of music that you make?
So I find that, when you go to a place that you're not familiar with, suddenly you're more focused and you're not distracted by all the little things that you could be distracted by in a familiar surrounding. I guess. Does that make sense?
Yeah, yeah. So how, if you compared it to us playing in our rehearsal studio versus playing here at Mike's?
It was exciting. There was this sense of oh, wow, what are we going to do here? Because it's we know what we can do at the other place. I think we've really, pushed that envelope to a point where we need to do a different thing.
Sophie, do you make, depending on where you make music, does that kind of affect the type of music you make? Or?
Oh, yeah, I think so, yeah. At the space, with the live drums, it definitely has more of a rock vibe. Yeah, last night it was more of a getting into the groove, and there were more electronic music playing. So that was the difference. I felt like we couldn't quite rock it.
Right.
Like the guitars, I could feel Mike was restraining himself a little.
Yeah.
So it was interesting, the different vibe we had.
Yeah. That and totally that. And then having us kind of split up where Sophie and I were in the other room, you guys were in here, was I actually really am intrigued by that idea of making music without seeing somebody.
Mm-hmm.
And, because technically, think about it. If you got comfortable at that, I could see down the road one possibility for people like us is like having sessions completely online,
where yeah,
you're
exactly.
just literally recording yeah. together yeah. from yeah. across the world.
Yeah, that, yeah that's Skyping
next,
and yes. stuff. Right?
That's
yeah.
next level.
Yeah.
yeah, right there.
Yeah,
it's like this. Little
These are the dreams
protection.
We had. Me and I feel very strongly that you guys probably too. Like back decades ago, where it was just like. Could you imagine a recording situation? Can you imagine a place where you can make your own recordings? Like not 4-track. 4-track was cool too, but like at this level where you visualize stuff, you edit it, you kind of like tinker and have fun with it and all these different tools in your home.
And the quality.
And the quality does
that
not.
That was the issue.
Yeah. yeah.
All that hiss. We got so used to it, right?
Yeah.
Put the Dolby on or the doubly.
the doubly.
Yeah.
It's got doubly.
I forgot about doubly. yeah.
If anyone doesn't know, that's a Spinal Tap reference.
Yep. Yeah. the doubly. I think having limitations on what you can do is really interesting to me. So, like, yeah. different spaces will have. Yeah, we can't set up live drums here, you know?
Right.
So. How does that affect what you do? And it's always interesting to me as a creative, like in terms of just creativity,
but you
can do when you're limited.
You could set
yes.
the drums. You could mm-hmm. set drums up in here, but then they would be played differently.
Yeah,
like put towels on them, use mallets and brushes, and that to me, I learned.
You could. Oh, finish that.
I was saying I learned drums that way.
The other thought I had too was because I used to do this on my like sort of old solo tracks was just junk percussion. You know, just finding household items.
Right.
You know, and
you were good at that,
and miking them up, and then just playing that, and just.
You can vary speed it a little bit too, right? You can if you've got a
so
pitch thing on
really
your
cool
track.
About the different environments too is like you can make the music that fits,
yeah.
That plays to whatever is in that environment. You know.
See? that she's found this mother. She's standing up for another. Now that she's found this mother, she's standing up for another. For another. Give her time, if I give her me.
Somebody told us, come see. naturally. Sometimes we remind each other rather not that she minds to do another. Told us comes naturally. Sometimes we remind each other rather not that she minds to do another. We'll be right back.
sorry, this is a funny aside, but Sophie, do you call Darren D sharp sometimes?
Now she does, yeah. It's never for a good reason.
No, when it's not good, I call him Shepherd.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
That's D sharp is Shepherd.
That's when you're in trouble, huh?
Yeah, which is
Shepherd.
Shepherd.
Sophie. Don't have a nickname yet.
Ooh,
but Michael, Mike can work on that.
Oh, I can tweet.
Fifi.
Oh. That's another dog name, right? Sorry.
Fifi.
Hello,
So-so.
Hello, Fifi.
Salut, Fifi.
Bonjour.
Bonjour, comment ça va?
Oh, bonjour, ça va.
On the east coast. mountain in a dream, you're all I know. No, it's so, only ever seen this mountain in a dream. This mountain in a dream. Yeah, there's rain. Don't pretend you're right. Don't pretend you're right. Don't pretend you're right. Don't know what I'm doing. Don't know what I'm doing. It's everything I've seen. It's everything, everything I've seen. But if we look the last, things we took are fast. The very things that last, we are granted.
If I can just say one thing, we have friends or we've known people who make music that's traditional or like it's capturing a moment, but sometimes it's so safe and so carefully done.
Yeah,
you feel like you kind of like gets you nervous.
Yeah.
So I believe like good Irish music has to be, you know, you have to be drinking a shot while you play. No, but you know what I mean. There's a certain element that has to be included, or it doesn't come off like authentic enough, you know. You've got to kind of loosen up and feel it rather than like read it off the page, you know. And that's the difference in that kind of folk music.
Yeah, because it is both of those are, it's, they're meant to be experienced live. You're supposed to be in a pub, in the moment, jumping around like a huge group of people, you know, just kind of,
and everyone kind of knows the song, so they can all join in if they want.
That's one thing I love about sort of the English culture, and maybe French too. I don't know, but is that sort of the group sing along? Oh, you know, let's go to a football match. I was in London a couple years ago. We went out and we were driving back and we were on the night bus. You know, which is so everyone getting out of the bars, and then you go to the upper level and the whole top level is just busted out singing Oasis Wonderwall, you know.
Oh my
god.
Today's
gonna be the day that it
it's not a tuneful song.
By now everybody feels the way I do about you now.
So you do it better, man.
Merci beaucoup. And then everyone busts into the chorus, you know.
Yeah. And that's the thing, because it's like
it was nice, long. Yeah. I loved it. And that never happens in America, man. Everyone's, it, in a weird way, it's like America's shy in their own, you know, obviously you go to American music shows, people can get pretty raucous and dancey and things, but there's a certain...
There's an intellectualism, I think, in America. Like that's why like great bands like Grateful Dead are so influential in the classic rock world. I feel like in America,
it almost, music is almost kind of seen like, oh, that's the musicians do it, or the professionals do it.
Yeah, whereas, I get you. Yeah. There's a separation.
In other cultures, it's like, yeah, everybody does it. We're all part, everyone can sing. You know, it's not singers. It's not only singers who can sing.
Right.
Yeah. But everyone can sing, and it's more participatory in that way, which I really appreciate.
It's like the old campfire thing, you know, like just sitting, you know, it's what people did. Right? I'll sit around the piano and let's play some songs that we all know.
We need his guidance against the enemies of hate. Call for the courage in the days to come, and we need his guidance against the enemies of hate.
Sorry, everybody. Some music. This is part two. Do we still have energy? How are you feeling, Sophie? Sophie's putting on her headphones right now. That means it looks like she's about to do something.
Listening to this episode of The New Signal.
Thank you, everybody.
Hope you had a good time. 2018 will be an exciting year. Follow us or subscribe to the podcast on iTunes and Amazon and Spotify. We're on Spotify now, too. You can get the podcast on Spotify. So if you want to reach out to us, let us know what you think. Tell us anything you like. You know, we want to hear from you. You can reach me at nat@thenewsignal.com. We've got Instagram and Twitter @thenewsignalpod. And until next time, see you later. Thank you.
Nourse with her apron and cap. She lit the fire, she fetched a wee broom, and she tidied and swept his tiny tree room. Cobbler, oh cobbler, mend my shoe. Oh, cobbler, mend my shoes.